Hey folks, I am sick of talking about the apocalypse, so let's talk about something fun and productive like my garden. Let's do it. Hey folks, thank you to the subscribers who let me know that when I created this video earlier today, the sound was completely cut off right in the middle of the video. So I'm gonna try this again. I'm gonna show you guys my garden. It's a windy day and I'm gonna watch the video all the way through to make sure that the sound does not cut off. Please make sure that you're using an updated device because YouTube has updated their sound so that if you're using an older device, the sound is gonna be a much lower quality. So you just saw the part where I showed you what my yard looked like about a week ago. It's been like this for about two or three days. So it took me 4 days in total to complete the project and I did everything myself. So you walk out my back door and the first thing you see is my laundry room slash storage shed. I'm not gonna go in there cause it's just a mess. But I painted the door black and put this pretty wreath on it that was used for showing my other house. All right, so backyard is here is what it looks like now. It's very bright, but you can see that it goes, I've got these little, okay, so this sand is decomposed granite, two bags, and you use the decomposed granite below an artificial turf so that it makes it softer. And it worked out so well. If I would have known that artificial turf would look this good and be this easy to clean, I would have done it long ago. So I got the majority of the products at Home Depot, Lowe's, and Star Nursery in Bullhead City. So in Arizona, Mojave Desert. So I do want to talk to you guys real quick about the grocery store. And I want to kind of change your perceptions of fruit. So when you think of a fruit tree, you think of apples and oranges. And when people think of cactus fruit, they think of something entirely different. Well, the fact of the matter is that cactus fruit is just fruit. Just take the word cactus and you've got yourself a fruit bush or a fruit tree. And that's what it is. So before I moved here, I did a whole bunch of research on what I can grow in my climate in my area. I can grow tropical, citrus, and cactus. So those are my three options. So I'm looking for the most productive things that I can find that are that fall under those categories. I can't grow apples here, I can't grow cherries or pears, what most people think, but I can grow a lot of different things that people aren't really accustomed to. And the reason that is because at the grocery store, you get things that are mass produced, easy to transport, and have a long shelf life. A lot of the things that I'm growing don't have a long shelf life, but they're very easy to grow. And I'm just getting started. So when I lived in California, you guys saw my garden and I was there for 10 years. And before I started YouTube, I was already 7 years in. So I already had a productive garden before I started YouTube. So this is gonna take 2 to 3 years. And yes, the best time to plant a garden was 10 years ago, but the second best time to do it is now. And because I'm a prepper, I have to prep for my climate. Please keep in mind that I cannot have animals here because it's too hot. And I am 1/4 mile from the Colorado River. So fishing and duck hunting is not a problem if there's ever an SHTF. So not a problem. So let's first go ahead and start over here. I've got my four solar panels, which are Renogy, which are hooked up to my Kodiak over here in the backup battery, which powers my living room every day. So it's got my TV, DVD player, my Roku box, my computer, modem, and a lamp. And I'm gonna try tomorrow to see if it'll also power my refrigerator at the same time, because I get great sun over there. So when it comes to the plants, over here, I've got a pomegranate in the corner because pomegranate grows really good in the desert. And If you see here, I got lucky and it already has a pomegranate on. Here is a cactus fruit. So it's here. So what this little cactus fruit will do is it'll grow more of these little red balls. And this is prickly and sharp. This is not. This is soft and there's no pricklies on it. So you don't have to worry about that. And I found out that if you see any cactus that has fruit on top, all of the fruit is sweet and delicious, nutritious, and nothing on a cactus is ever toxic if it's a fruit. That doesn't mean the same for the other stuff, but all the fruit on any cactus is not toxic, so it's all edible. And if I would have known that in California, I would have had a lot more foraging videos. So behind me, this guy, Indian fig. So I want you to think about fruit, an Indian fig, so it's gonna grow figs on it. Figs, from what I hear, I've never had them, but they taste like a very, very sweet watermelon. Also, on this, I'm not gonna let it grow too much. I'm gonna be doing a lot of pruning because these pads are edible too. So you cut them up. So then you come over here. This is just an orange tree. You guys know what oranges look like, but it's citrus and I can grow it. Moving on to the artificial lawn. Funny story about the lawn. I went to Lowe's and they were at the end of their roll for the artificial lawn. And she said, I think I only have 8 feet left. And I said, that's fine. I'll take your last 8 feet. It's 12 feet and that's how they charge you. She said, I think I only have 8 feet. I said, that's great. You know, I'll take 8 feet. And she rolls it up. I put it in my car. I go back to pay. And she says, I think it's a little bit more than 8 feet. And I said, that's totally okay. You know, I'll work around it. No problem. I roll it out. It's 12 by 12. She only charged feet. Okay, so over here, these are the ones that I'm the most excited about. These are dragon fruit, and some stores will carry dragon fruit if you live in the Southwest or in California. I don't think they would make it to the East Coast, but dragon fruit is one of my favorite things to have for breakfast, and one dragon fruit is $6. That's why I started growing artichokes in California, because the artichokes were $4 each, and I was like, I love artichokes, but I can't be paying $4 an artichoke. So I am growing 8 dragon fruits. These will eventually grow. So I'm trying to get them to grow outward instead of upward, because that's just the way I want the garden to look. And each dragon fruit, 20 of them. That's 20 times 6, like $120 worth of dragon fruit. But it's my favorite fruit. My favorite breakfast, and they're delicious. I'm really looking forward to that. Behind me, I've got female flowering pygmy date palms. So you can purchase dates, and they're in Egypt. That's where they do the most producing of them, which is a desert climate. And date palms usually grow up to be like 75 feet tall. And I got a pygmy option. Because I don't want to store a 75-foot ladder, nor do I want to climb it to get some dates. These will eventually grow up to about the size of the fence, and they will cover the solar panels eventually, which I'll just move the panels. But I'm really looking forward to those. If you've ever tried dates, they are considered to be nature's sugar. A lot of people use them as a sweetener in coffees and sorbets and stuff like that. I've got another dragon fruit here. And then I planted some lavender because you plant lavender for luck. And I like having good luck. And over here I've got a sitting area. I don't know why I chose those bricks, but I can't cement anything in here, like real cement, because that's where all the plumbing for the house is. And I already had a $4,000 plumbing issue. So now I have all new plumbing, but if there ever is another issue, I don't want them to come in with a jackhammer and leave a giant hole in my yard again. So I left it with bricks that you can still move. So here's where my yard gets weird, the shape. Oh, the climate. So people were concerned when I said I was gonna paint my fence black, and they thought that it might make the temperature in here hotter, but because of where I put the fences, there's a lot less wind, but it's also about 10 degrees cooler than when you step out into the rest of the yard, which is, so it's like its own little climate, its own little climate. So I'm working on a trail here. I'm building a little trail, as you can see, because the ground here is nothing but sand and river rock. So I have piles and piles. That pile is from when I did this. Lots of fig over here, which is the first tree that I planted. It's a turkey fig.
Hold on.
I'll just do this. It's a turkey fig, and they grow those a lot in the Mediterranean and in rocky. I don't know if you can see them. They almost died from the heat, but I put them over there where they get more care. This is just extra wood from when I cut the fences to create the fences. And it's not pre-treated. Just walk over here. And my plan for this is to be completely full of trees, and also a trellis that goes over the trail. And the trellis that goes over the trail, I'm going to be planting passion fruit and grapes because those grow really well here. And mangoes and papayas, hopefully someday bananas. But lots of oranges and lemons because I love lemons. I only drink coffee and water, but I drink also lemon water, and I love lemon water. Over here I've got a grape going. It's brand new. It's like a couple months old, and it's right there. It'll eventually go up and work its way into the trellis, and that's just a storage thing that it's pretty much empty. It's just got some old metal junk in there, and I use the roof for my smaller solar and my R600. I'll stick the panel on top. I only have to charge my Jackery's about once a week. So, oh, one other thing somebody asked me. These little wood things, I surrounded the cactus plants so that Rocky wouldn't step in them. He didn't help. I mean, it kind of helped, but not really. But so those things, they sell these borders at Home Depot. There's like six of those wood pieces for like $10. But if you remember from my old house, I used to have borders, and I had them here for a while. If you look in the picture right before I do this, these. So this is $3. So I just took a table saw and cut them up into shorter pieces, not the same size, like they're supposed to be, not the same size, and made my own borders for $3 for like 15 pieces instead of $10 for 5 or 6. So it was just a big money saver there. I'm not sure what else there is because I'm not done. This is only a third of my yard, and I have a lot to do in the back. You know, this only took a week, but I'm also on a budget. So, I've got the back part to do, and then my front yard is twice the size as my backyard. So, I've got a lot of work to do. And I can't do a lot till March because most of the stores and nurseries are like completely out of plants that I want or that grow well here. They have a lot of annuals, but not like perennials or fruit or berry bushes or things like that. They're just out. I also tried getting a water fountain out here, and everybody's out of water fountains. Nobody, even Amazon has a back order on the ones that I like until like October. So I'm too impatient. I just planted an orange tree instead. Okay, so that is what I've got going on so far. And I'm hoping, I'm gonna have to watch this whole video to make sure that the sound comes through. Yeah. And in the front yard, I will be planting moringa first. So I'm sure that you preppers are aware of moringa. It is the ultimate prepper food tree. It's leaf, every single part of the tree is edible, all the way down to the bark and the roots and the nuts or beans that it produces in the leaves. So even the leaves are higher in potassium than bananas, higher in calcium than milk, higher in vitamins B than oranges. It's just like the ultimate prepper food. So that's what I've got going on in my backyard so far. And I do have company coming next week, so I'm hoping that she won't mind being on video. It's going to be her birthday, so I'm making her favorite Oreo truffles. And we're going to hopefully grab some sea-doos out on the river. Maybe she'll be up for fishing or something. I'm not sure. So that's what I've got going on for now. Do what you can with what you've got. Prepper Princess out.